Hello, it's time for fractals. Let's start by writing a small code to create a fractal tree and to understand how recursive works. We will use pygame, so let's import it. Also, we will calculate some angles, so we need some math functions. Next, let's define our pygame's window size and initiate the pygame itself. Okay, let's create pygame screen, maybe define screen size. We can also add a caption to pygame's window. Let's name it fractal tree. Next, we create a usual pygame's while loop where everything will happen. For now, just fill background with black color and create for loop to close our while loop if we press Windows close button. Okay, now let's create our fractal's tree function. You will need starting coordinates x1 and y1. We will start drawing our tree. A starting angle and a depth, how many levels of branches we want to draw. Otherwise, in a while loop, it will go forever. Let's start by adding two variables. Fork angle, it will define how many degrees new branch rotates from existing one, and base length, how long the branch will be. Next, we will create if statement, stating how many levels of branches we want, and if it reaches depth of 0, it will stop. Okay. So what we need to do next is to calculate coordinates of our branch end, x2 and y2. Next, we can draw our branch with defined coordinates x1, y1 and x2, y2. We add also some delay between drawings, not to see all three at once, and update the pygame window. And finally comes the recursive part, where we call the same function in a function. Just now we have new starting coordinates and we have lower depth. We are calling two times to have two branches in different directions, minus fork angle and plus fork angle. Now we just need to call the drawTree function in pygame's while loop with starting parameters. We define that tree should start in middle bottom of the screen, facing up and with depth of 5. Let's run and see the result. We created a simple fractal tree using recursive. In the next part, we will create a universal code for displaying various kinds of fractals using LSystem. So before starting, I recommend to check this page. Here you can find all necessary information about fractals, starting with explanation of what is a fractal at all, how it can be drawn using Python. That classical way is by using Turtle model. That it just needs three basic commands. And a short info about LSystem, Lied-Meyer system, and how it uses a string of characters. We will also use the system because it's clear and universal. Here you can also find a lot of fractal examples and parameters to generate them. You can see we just need to input 4 lines of strings. Actually 3 is enough because the number of iterations just says how many levels or iterations it is recommended to have. Let's move to code. Okay, so what we need to do? We need to have a code for reading a txt file with information about fractals parameters and how to create it. Next, we need a system class to create a fractal with defined txt input and finally a pygame environment to display everything. Let's start with reading a txt file. First, we need to import pygame and math libraries and initialize the pygame itself. Next, we define our screen size and create LSystem text variable, which we assign to our fractals txt file. We will store all txts in fractal folder. Let's see one of the txts. First line is axiom. It's a base for creating a fractal. Next line defines how many rules we have. The rules are defined in the third line and last line defines the angle. Okay, so let's read this txt file and assign all lines to variables. Let's open txt file as f. So first line will be axiom. Next line number of rules. If we will have more than one rule, we need to for loop through them and to store them. For storing, let's create rules dictionary. So we run for loop and split line of rules by empty space and store separated rules in a dictionary. And the last line will be angle, we will use radians for simplicity. Okay, let's print all variables to test if everything is working. Looks good. We have one rule. It says that f must be changed to ff plus f plus plus f plus f, and this should go to our axiom. Let's move to another part. We will create our LSystem class and form a fractal string of characters. Our class will have three attributes: axiom, rules, and angle. Self-sentence we will assign to axiom, self-rules to rules, and self-angle to angle. Next, we will create a dender method rewriting what we should get when we want to get a string, we want to get our sentence. And we will create a method which will generate fractal string of characters. We will store a new string in a new sentence variable. For start, we assign it to empty string. Next, we follow through our characters in a sentence and map it itself if it's key not in the rules dictionary, or map it what it's supposed to be. We also add exception to pass when we concatenate what we map, and finally assign new sentence to self sentence. For testing, let's add a print sentence to see if new string is generated according to rules. Let's create a class object and call generate method. Let's run. Okay, we have an axiom f plus f plus f plus f. It's very simple. And we have one rule, meaning that f in axiom must be changed to ff plus f plus plus f plus f. So basically our new sentence should repeat 4 times the rule. This is exactly what we have. To draw fractals, we need more than just 3 parameters. We need to know the starting position where our fractal begins to draw on the window, length of fractal's branch, and ratio if this branch stays the same length or decreases. Because we will need different parameters for different fractals, we will input them separate. So let's add sys library and assign all our variables to sys argument input values. Next, we need to update our system class by adding additional attributes parameters. We will add start, length, and ratio. For start, we will have self-start and separate coordinates, self-x and self-y. We also need starting angle theta. To face up, we need to rotate by 90 degrees. Because we're using radians, it will be pi divided by 2. We also need a new attribute positions. For now, it will be an empty list. Let's move to generate method. Here we also need to add self x and self y equal to self start, the starting angle theta, and self length multiplied by self ratio. Let's delete the print statement. We don't need it anymore. Next, we need a new method for drawing a fractal. We will need to input just screen variable. We will iterate through our fractal string of characters, and if we will find f letter, this will mean that we need to go forward. So we calculate new coordinates straight in front, and we draw the line on the screen with new coordinates. After that, we assign new starting coordinates to just calculated. If we will find plus char, we will rotate to the right by self angle, and rotate to the left if we will find minus char. We also could find square brackets. If we will find open square bracket, we will append x, y, and theta values to position list as dictionary. And if we will find the closing square bracket, we will pop the last entry from positions list and assign self x, self y, self theta to positions values. And this is it, the LSystem class. Next, we need to create a function to run all the code and to see fractal in Pygames window. Let's create main function. Here we define our Pygames screen and also add a line to hide mouse pointer. Next, we add while loop for running our Pygames window and define that we stop the loop and the code by pressing Pygames window close button. And don't forget to update the Pygames window. Now we can create LSystems class object. Not to run our fractal code infinity, let's define that it will show one iteration at a time if we press a defined keyboard key. It will be a space key. When it pressed, we will fill the background with black color, call the draw method, and generate another iteration of fractal. If we press escape key, we will close the window. And let's call the main function. Okay, so now we need to input all arguments to see if it works. We need to define fractals.txt, starting position, rank of the branch and variation. I already prepared some examples. So we need just to copy a line to a terminal. Here we call Python, fractal spy code, and define my just mentioned parameters. Let's copy to the terminal and run it. Okay, so by pressing space it moves to next iteration and with the escape it closes. Let's try another example. Looks quite good, but I think we can add some colors. For colors we will use colorsys library. Let's create a function hsv to RGB. It's a simple one-liner. And in a draw method, instead of white color, we add our just created function with input hue 1 and 1. We will change color using hue at each character in the sentence. Let's add base hue value of 0 to the start and incrementation to the end. Let's see the next example. We have colors, now it looks a lot better. Next you can see some fractal examples. Thanks for watching, and if you have any questions, leave it in the comment section. You will find the code in the video description, and if you liked this video, please leave a like and hit the subscribe button for more Python videos.